Hey y'all, thanks for tuning in to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and for the entire month of July, I want to stay focused for us on social media marketing. So this week specifically, we'll be talking about Facebook and YouTube. The next week, we'll be looking at Periscope and Twitter. The third week of the month, we're going to take a look at Pinterest and Instagram. And then the final week of the month, we're going to look at social media marketing sharing tools and kind of work management tools, all for social media marketing inside of WordPress. We're going to be looking at specific plugins and all sorts of cool ways to not only use these social media networks, but also how to get them involved inside of your website. So stick around, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Every single week we're producing some sort of cool video like this for you, specifically with WordPress. All right, so let's take a look initially at Facebook. I know everybody says you need a Facebook account and you gotta use Facebook, but what the heck, how do you use it? I wanna show you here, this is our Webtegrity Facebook page. Check this out, there you go. There's our Webtegrity Facebook page. You can kind of see some of the engagement that we have, some of the interaction that we have, some of the different posts that we do. I know a lot of times though, my clients and our students wonder, what is the best thing to post on your social networks? What's a hashtag? How often should I be posting? What types of things can I actually put on here to get the best engagement? So I want to teach you just for a moment, first of all, what a hashtag is, looking inside of your Facebook account. So you're going to see here I've started this post. We'll be learning about social media marketing this month on WordPress Wednesday. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for our WordPress videos. And then I put the link here over to our YouTube channel. And then it also created this from that link. So I mentioned here first, we'll be learning about social media marketing. And I went ahead and put them all together. All three words became one word. I used the hashtag on it so that it would basically create this hot link, if you will. You put a hashtag, all the words together. You can put each word having a capitalization, or you don't have to. It's just easier to read sometimes if you do that with each word. This month on WordPress, and so WordPress, of course, is one of our keywords, and I put a hashtag there. And then notice that I mentioned WordPress again. You don't need to have both of them hashtagged. There's no reason for that. This one works, and we'll pull up this post as people are looking for things WordPress inside of Facebook. So I'm just gonna go ahead and publish. Or if I wanted to, this is something really cool inside of Facebook, I could schedule this to publish at a later time, a later date. So I want you to note that as we get to the end of this month, you'll see it as well. There are resources out there where you don't have to be active every single day on your social networks. You can actually come in here and work proactively and schedule things so it'll look like you're doing things every single day of the week, but really maybe you only spent a lazy Sunday afternoon coming in here and scheduling up, you know, the week or the month of posts if you really wanted to. For now, I'm going to go ahead and publish this post. Of course, things that have photos on them are going to get higher engagement. Things that have video get the most engagement, and that's why we're going to be talking about YouTube here in just a moment. You'll want to have all sorts of different things that you're posting when it comes to your social networks, and this is kind of across the board. You'll want to have things that you're talking about your business itself. You'll want to also have things that you're talking about going on in your industry as a whole. You'll also want to have freebie tips and tricks and resources, things like that, that people in your industry, your customers, your clients would be interested in. So I really want to have things on here where we're talking about free opportunities. That's what you're doing here, is you're coming here and looking at our free WordPress tutorial. So this is one of my give back posts or freebie posts. This is something fun. This is a geek fact of the day. We just wanted to throw that out there. But you're going to see the level of engagement change a little bit. That's why I wanted to show you this. We mentioned the 4th of July. And then we mentioned here again our YouTube channel. Look at the post here though with Webtegrity. I could have changed this to read out more. Just by clicking on it here, it would have allowed me to read out more or to type out more there in that area. This one's talking a little bit about WordPress again and then mentioning a couple of our websites that we've done some video on. Let me scroll down here though to show you one that's gotten more engagement. Here's a geek fact, got 47 people connected with it. This one here is the one I wanted to show you. Notice here I've put the actual video right here on the post, and I did that just by adding the link on here to the actual video itself. So this appears right here. If I clicked on it, I could watch it right here. This one engaged 71 people. That's a pretty high engagement. Here's another one that only reached 19. Here's a geek fact, the happy Father's Day to the Star Wars, to the father of Star Wars, 58 people. It's interesting to monitor. The reason why I'm mentioning this is it's interesting to monitor all of your different posts to kind of see what your audience is enjoying and liking. And then you can kind of adjust your writing calendar to start to engage on those that are getting higher engagement. So let's talk about the best plugins for WordPress for Facebook. This is by far one of my favorites, custom Facebook feed. Remember that I'll put the link to all of these in the description box below. So just click on show more down below and you'll be able to see all the links to get to these. This is a free version of a custom Facebook feed. Basically what you'll come here to the description area here and you'll get to see all the different things that it allows you to do. It's pretty fantastic. I wanted to show you though what it could look like, a screenshot here of what it could look like on your website. It has a darker version like this, as well as a lighter version. So if your website's white background, it could look like this. If your website has a darker background, it could look like this, but you can customize anything you'd like. It also has the ability to scroll inside the frame itself, and it's fully responsive, which is another really outstanding feature of this plugin. And it's very user-friendly to set up and engage inside your website. One of the reasons why you want to have your feed visible on your site, though, is that's fresh content happening on your website for a search engine optimization, as well as people get to see immediately that you're active doing things over on Facebook. A lot of our clients also use their Facebook as their main point of announcing certain things, events, sales, opportunities happen over there, and they really don't have a place on their website necessarily to have things like that going on. So if you brought over your Facebook feed, solves both problems, and you only have to post it once. This is what you don't want to have happen though. Whenever you go to look for a Facebook feed, you don't want to see this. This plugin hasn't been updated for over 2 years. You want to be sure that everything you're using is completely up to date. So even later on as you're reviewing this and I'm telling you, hey, this custom Facebook feed plugin's awesome, I want you to come here and be sure that it's been updated recently, that it's compatible with the version you're using, and that it has really outstanding reviews still. Just to be sure that you're using something up to date. This is another really awesome Facebook plugin, Feed Them Social. It offers a couple of different social media networks on here to use, but their Facebook feed is pretty extraordinary. So if you wanted to kind of run one that allows you to do multiple social networks, this one right here is pretty outstanding, Feed Them Social. Again, I'll put the link to this in the description box below. If you're trying to get people to just like your Facebook post or your posts rather on your blog area of your website or maybe your pages talking about your services and you just want to add a Facebook like button to those pages, this is a pretty great plugin that'll allow you to do that. Super easy to use, super simple. I'll put that in the description box below as well. Facebook comments. If you'd like to have a discussion area going on your blog where people can use their Facebook page, or perhaps you'd like people to be able to comment on your actual products, you can use this plugin for that as well. Pretty cool. They also have a really great extensive, that same plugin has a really great extensive support area where you can go and just read easily how to do everything. All you do is copy, you activate the plugin, and then you copy this short code inside of the page where you want it to appear. It works perfectly that way. All right, so let's look at YouTube. Y'all, that's the next one we want to discuss. And this is just going to be brief because, as you know, if you follow my channel, we've also created this awesome, awesome video that talks about 25 different plugins that you can use for YouTube or Vimeo. Either one of those video networks. This one has a complete list, and some of these are still pretty great. I've updated a few of them, letting you know what I still think about them. But I'm going to put the link to this awesome video tutorial in the description box below. Go check out this awesome resource for you. So one of the reasons why you want to be using YouTube, you don't have to have a whole lot of expensive equipment to make a video. You see what I'm doing here, and we have over 11,000 subscribers on our YouTube channel. What you need to do is have good content. Or if you have somebody who wants to give a review to your business or your product, take a quick 30-second testimonial with your awesome phone. I mean, it's just a couple of seconds that you can take a quick testimonial, post it on a YouTube channel, give it a great title. Use YouTube. It keeps people on your website longer. It allows them to click right here and watch the video instead of going over to YouTube. They're going to be spending the time on your own website, which is so important these days. I've got a great YouTube plugin here. It's a free one to use. It'll allow you to put a gallery on your website of different videos that either you have done or that you have created a playlist and you enjoy, those things can be embedded directly on your website. It's very, very important that you have people stay on your website to watch your videos. If you don't know how to embed a video on your website, I've already created a YouTube tutorial on how to do that. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. And if you're looking for something a little bit more premium, I also did a review recently on this plugin for a gallery for videos. This is pretty extraordinary. It has a lot of really cool options. It's only 18 bucks. And again, this is my tutorial video for that. So I'll put the link to this in the description box below. Please start using Facebook on a regular basis. Please start using YouTube on a regular basis, and you're going to see your search engine optimization on your website totally increase. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. I will see you next week. Bye, y'all.